Hey, Sam. Are you not... Okay, there you go. Alright. Controller power's activated. Whoa. What was with these frame rates? I specifically turned down the graphics. I guess it's not... That was weird. I turned down the graphics so it wouldn't have issues. I guess Twitch or... Did I have OBS set up wrong? I'll check when I get back to where? I don't know where I am. I just started the stream and I'm already lost. Oh, I know where I am. I know where I am. That's the way to the Indigo Quarry, so I need to go back home. I found out how to get hey, Sun Gaming, and Tuties. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I got the level 3 treasure cracker. So the thing with the treasure crackers, they're actually unlocked not by getting treasure, but by running through extractor cycles. So you just build a bunch of stupid extractors like this guy that... I did not realize you were still out here. I need to double check something on... Ah, why are they so loud? I hate how loud they are. Hold on. I'm gonna turn the sound effects down. Master music. Oh, that would explain it. Yeah, these things are way too annoying, the extractors. Oh yeah, but the I got the last thing, the treasure cracker. And so it turns out the treasure crackers are just unlocked by... You need, I think, like just 10 extraction cycles, like 10 outputs of an extractor for the treasure cracker one. It's like 50 for this one, and it's like 100 for the last one. So I got all of them now, and we're gonna go explore for the things, though. First things first, I need to find why OBS is being weird. Are you... Oh, my CPU isn't... I have high kernel times again. I still don't know what that means. I've got... If you go to details and task manager, I've got 30% system idle. But if you go to the performance tab, it's like... Well, I guess it's not too different now, but it was. It used to be on... I don't know. I guess it's probably because the game is paused, but let's... Are you not using the right resolution? Wait, why are you streaming at 200? There you go. I don't know why OBS is being weird. I did set you to 720p, didn't I? Yeah, you're 720p. You shouldn't be this weird. Treasure crackers sound like a delicious cookie. They have delicious treats inside of them. Or they open delicious treats, rather. What's the end point of the game? It's like Harvest Moon, sort of. Why we have so much lag? I guess this area I should expect lag. But, let's drop down those graphics to default, I guess. The end point, I guess I'm basically, you could say that I am at the end point. Oh, whoops, hold on. I need to bring up... I've got a list of the locations for the treasure pods. Few differences in the chat now here on YouTube. You can only type 200 characters. Yeah, I think... I don't personally have a problem with long chat stuff in streams. As long as people aren't spamming it. But, yeah, for some reason, the like most stream chat things tend to limit you quite a lot. But yeah, I think Twitch already has a fair... I don't know. I think Beam cuts you off eventually. Yeah, I think they all have limiters at some point. What am I doing here again? Alright, now I just need to go out in the field and find some treasure crackers. That's Hunter Feral section of Moss Blanket. But yeah, I've streamed this a few times. Not usually on the weekends, like typical stream. But, I think I might have to downgrade our encoding quality a bit here.
very fast. Let's go to super fast, I guess.
Oh, this also might be part of why I'd like. I decided to find out how many pink slimes I could fit in a cage. It turns out it's an incredible amount, and this was probably a dumb idea. I should probably just get rid of these guys. Yeah, this is a ranching game. You pretty much just you ranch, you know. You don't unlock all of the stuff, but hey, small birds. Let's just get rid of all of these pink slimes. Oh yeah, hope everybody had a good Thanksgiving. And if you didn't, that's okay too. Where did I put this teleporter to go to? Oh. Oh yeah, I made a teleporter to go to where the hunter slimes spawn. I'm not sure if this is useful for go to the lake, the mushroom section. Oh hey, the pod should be underwater. Oh yeah, there's a treasure pod, like right here. Yeah, I wanted to just find all the treasure pods. And then I could edit a video together with the location, which probably, you know. I didn't do this like the very first day the update came out, so I'm probably already too late. But in two Thanksgiving dinners, you're going to weigh 1,000 pounds. I just had one, and it was plenty. So we got a jumbo shroom. Not a regular shroom, or even a large shroom. No, something more. It's the, I regret not reading some of the flavor text. The flavor text in this game is pretty good. In Volcanic Island, close to the center ring. Okay, not Hunter Feral section, one-way teleporter, and the last jump before the ramp that takes you. Okay, so there's two in the moss blanket, so I'm gonna head out to the moss blanket. Why is my... It feels like my sensitivity is too low. Hold on. Something feels weird. Input. X sensitivity. Move that up a bit. Yeah, it feels a bit better. Alright, cousins came over. That's cool. My sister usually flies in for Christmas and New Year's, but Thanksgiving is a bit too long. You know, between those two. I did not successfully avoid politics this year, but it could have been worse, I guess. It was, eh. This year's a bit different politics-wise. I usually manage to avoid the whole political stuff. Let's get some water here while I'm here. Yeah, the point of this game is basically you just adventure, you find a bunch of slimes, you bring them back to your ranch, you get these crystals from the slimes, and you make stuff now. The making stuff is mostly new. Like this crafting now. You used to be able to buy corrals for the slimes and stuff. Do you chance have monitoring software running in the background? I don't really think so. I don't know why it's being iffy today. Huh. Slime Rancher is using more CPU than it usually does. One drive, god damn it. That's the culprit. One drive, why do you... Can you set a schedule for one drive? It's even on a limit. Why is it using so much CPU? Holy crap. Photos and video, what? Why doesn't OneDrive know well enough to not do stuff while I'm, like, using my freaking computer? Pause syncing for 24 hours. Why are you stupid, OneDrive? Okay. OneDrive is gone. I'm pretty sure that's the only thing that could have been an issue. Yeah, this is not the first time OneDrive has caused an issue. I really like OneDrive, but why is it stupid? Okay, that feels a bit better. Why is OneDrive stupid? I really like OneDrive, and like, all I needed to do is just not use CPU while I'm using my computer. Like, come on. Wait, how are the frames? I guess it doesn't look like we're dropping frames yet, so that's good. Mediacom has still not checked out my streaming issues. They keep rescheduling for like weekdays when I'm not here, and I asked them if I could do it on the weekend or after 5, and they haven't got back to me yet. It's a small island with circular stones shortly after entering the Hunter Ferals section and a moss blanket. A bit of a distance from the... There's a tall stump in the water. Oh, I think I know where this one is. Yeah, I don't think there's any sync, like... There's no schedule setting, which is stupid. I think it's oh! Gotta let the thing recharge. I wish there was an upgrade that just gave you infinite run, or like only drained your run when tars are. What game was that? I played a game where, oh yeah, Yomawari. In Yomawari, you have a stamina meter, but oh shit, it's one of those. What do I do? Fuck! I hate those things. I hit it with stuff. Golden slimes are so freaking stupid. That's the worst part of the game, in my opinion. There's an achievement tied to those stupid things. And you gotta spray them with a bunch of stuff to get their plorts, and it's dumb and I hate it. I don't think this is the part where I thought it... No, this is not the area I thought I was going to. Feral Hunters. Yeah, I can set OneDrive to not use as much upload bandwidth, but it was just using like it was using a whole CPU core, and I don't know why. I don't know. What's weird is I wonder if they added if they made Slime Rancher use more CPU cores, because oh hey Hunter, they didn't use to spawn here, did they? Come here. Yeah, it's using more than one CPU core, which it never used to do. Ah, geometry, please. I really like this game, but there's definitely some level geometry issues. It's got very sticky geometry. Okay, I think... Keep going through the Hunter Feral section. I don't even... I guess this must be the Hunter Feral section? I think there's some Hunter Ferals here. Uh-oh. Hey, John. Yeah, there's some Hunter Ferals here, right? Alright. Small island with circular stones. Oh, yep, that's the Hunter Feral section. Hello, friends! Please don't eat me. Small island with circular stones. Oh, I remember. This one's way in the back. These descriptions aren't very good, in my opinion. I think it's this way. I haven't tried to stream since the last stream, obviously. I haven't streamed since Sunday, let's put it that way. Uh-oh. Oh! Dead. Oh well, at least I wasn't carrying anything. Thanksgiving was alright. I really need to get rid of these stupid slimes. I am impressed how many slimes you can hold in one cage, but it's not as practical as I thought it was, because it gives you some pretty bad slowdown. And they're not super productive. Like, you can only hold 100 plorts in the storage thing, so having over 100 slimes, you know, it's just not super practical. It is neat that you can immediately get infinite pink slimes now. The very first spawn point for pink slimes, it'll infinitely respawn them. So if you do want to make a slime, like, bouncy ball pit, you can do that. Which I do believe it is an achievement. let's go here. I still need to set up my other two teleports. I'm not sure where I want my teleports and depots yet, but this was a good place because there's some hunter slimes I can catch. But beyond that, I don't really know where a good place to have a two-way teleport would be. Oh, my water's gone too. Also, between the last stream, I totally revamped my, what's that place called? The sort of, like, wild side of the ranch with, you know, the wild-spawning chickens. I changed that to be all puddle slimes and some, free-range, feral boom slimes. The feral boom slimes, I figured they would eat a lot from the chickens and, like, drop a lot of plorts. It hasn't really been worth it, plort-wise. But, it's been nice to have all the puddle slimes. And it lets me refill my water, so I might just get rid of the boom hunters and just have it as a nice little place for all my puddle slimes. Yeah, OBS is using like 50% of CPU still. I wonder if I messed something up in my settings, or... I guess Slime Rancher is... I mean, there's a lot of movement, I guess. But it's only 720p. Hold on, let me... I wonder if I do game capture instead. Does game capture have better performance? Scale that. Fit to screen. Let's just try that. Maybe game capture is better than window capture. It looks about the same. Oh gosh, oh gosh. I was out of stuff. Jet Set Radio. I really love the idea, and like Jet Set Radio's style is like A+. The gameplay is like C, frankly. Like I played it on Vita, the remake or whatever, or the remaster, I guess. It was. Everyone seems to love Future though. I don't have an original Xbox, so I never got to play. There's that motherfucker. There's that gold motherfucker. I think he's already gone. I hate those things. I think they're more common now, though, maybe. But you have to have a bunch of crap on hand to smack it with. The gold slimes. Alright, so that's 2 out of 6. Red Warp Depot. Oh, nice! Okay, what else do we got? Keep walking through the Hunter Feral section of the Moss Mine until it finds the one plate. The last jump. Oh. Wait, what? Oh. There's another one in the moss blanket. This was not the one I thought it was. Yeah, is there some legal reason Jet Set Radio Future hasn't been ported? Because that's the one everyone seems to love, like even more than the original one. And it never got a port. And like being only on the original Xbox is so rough because you can't play it on, you know, Xbox One backwards compatibility doesn't do anything for you. Emulation won't do anything for you. Xbox 360 backwards compatibility isn't perfect, so you just have to have an original Xbox, and that's like not the most commonly, like that's not the best selling console ever, exactly. Hey, it's Lethal. So I'm not exactly sure where we're looking here. It's a small island with circular stone shortly after entering the Hunter Feral section in the moss blanket. A bit of a distance that is from a tall stump in the water. You can use the mushrooms in the small hollowed log that should be nearby. Other mushrooms or trees. So I think I'm looking for some weird little island. Oh, is it over there? No? Aw, come on. That seemed so obvious. Oh well. Must be somewhere else. Tree stump? No, it's a small island, it said. Hey, friends. I don't think it's over there. Is it up, maybe?
Small surge stones really after the hunt. You need to use the mushrooms on a hollow log that should be nearby. Other mushrooms are trees. It's a super hidden spot.
Is it? I wonder if it's up on one of these things, and they're just calling it an island when they shouldn't be. I'm pretty sure this is the area they're talking about. This is kind of why I wanted to make, you know, edit this together into a video guide, because these written descriptions seem kind of rough. I know there was one up there, but I forget if it was a black one or not. What am I hunting? I'm looking for the treasure pods. Oh yeah, I got that one. Big mushroom. Maybe it's over... Maybe it's here? Is it on this big mushroom? No. Thought the Jet Set 1 remaster would have made enough... Yeah, I don't know. They... Well, I have no concept of how well any of that stuff sells. Nobody... Steam Spy aside, no one really has or gives information on, like, game sales unless they want to. And then it's only the successes, you know? I really... Feral is a bit of a distance from that. It's this tall stump in the water. Okay, so... Is it on the tall stump? Okay, come on, refill. I think this must be the tall stump. Tall stump in the water. You need to use the mushrooms from a small hollowed log that should be nearby. In the small hollowed log and it should be nearby. I don't think this is where I think it is. Okay, there's a small hollowed log. Is that over here? I'm so confused. Has anybody found all of the treasure things themselves? Because I'm... This one's real confusing. Go to the lake that's in the mushroom section of the moss blanket. That should be a pond. I already got that one. Volcanic Island. I know where to get that one. Oh wait, hold on, there's a GIF. Ow, I'm dying. Uh-oh. Oh, no I'm not. Just loud noises. Hold on. Okay, so it is in a treasure... It is in a tree stump. This is like the least helpful GIF they could have possibly given. It confirms that it is in fact in a tree stump, and I don't recognize any other landmarkers. Wait, I think I see... I think it's that. I think it's that big tree. Aw, oh, frick. Ugh, okay. I think I know where it is now? So I figured I would already have this by now. Oh, thanks, Sam. Yeah, I always read all my comments. I always try to reply to my chat and everything. Let's get up here. Yeah, I'm always a little worried about what will happen if things get too big to, like, deal with. But, it's pretty nice to just be able to, you know, have some people in here and chat and just keep it pretty casual. Ugh, come on, jetpack, please. I figured this would just be a real quick thing and just get in, get out. I guess I was wrong about them not hiding anything where you needed to use tons of jetpacking to get to. unless this is... Oh, is it that maybe? Is it that one way out there? It's not this one. Oh, dang. The collision isn't even set here. I don't think I'm supposed to be here. I think it's that one way out there. Okay, yeah, I think it's this. Yeah, it's... I guess it's this. Yeah, this game looks pretty good. I'm playing it on pretty low graphical settings. Well, I mean, not the lowest, by any means. But, it can look better. And then, see? There we go. Okay. That's only 3 of 6. Amber teleporter. Alright. Volcanic Island. I know where this one is. So this one will be quicker. You know what? I don't care. Take me home. Yeah, always feel free to leave a comment on my channel or on my website. I read everything, and, you know, if it's too garbage or offensive, I'll have to delete it, but, you know. I keep my chat nice, that's what I... My comments nice, that's what I'm trying to say. Oh, we got another lava dust! Okay, so that is very good. The lava dust lets me make some of the few things that I haven't been able to make yet. It's just really rare material. I wish there was a third level of these extractors. It doesn't seem like there is. But yeah, let's see if we can make anything while we're here. On Sun Gaming, as long as your refund request was in Steam's, like, you know, less than 2 hours played, have had it for only a week or something, it's basically it is automatic, so you should get it. You should hear back pretty soon. I did that for a game that was on sale. Like, they said you could do that, you know, if a game goes on sale after you buy it. And I did that, and it, you know, completely, you know, simple. Let's make that nice red one. Oh, I don't have explosive plorts. Wait, I should have... I have... Where's my explodey dudes? Here. I've been pleasantly surprised with how not awful these guys have been. I only have 15 in there. It seems if you have only 15, no matter what species of Largo you have, 15 is always safe. It's not the most you can cram in there by any means, but it's always safe, and if you feed them their favorite food, it's pretty much always enough. Honey needs mangoes, yes. Speaking of Steam sale, I was looking on Steam, and they don't have Sim Tower. I was playing Project Hi-Rez. I was actually kind of tempted to stream that. I'll probably do a VOD. I don't know. But yeah, I've been playing Project Hi-Rez, and that's pretty fun. I do see some... There's some annoyances I have. A lot of people seem to not like it because it doesn't have the elevator management from Sim Tower. If you're not familiar, Project Hi-Rez is basically literally Sim Tower, but, you know, more modern. But I never liked the elevator management in Sim Tower. It was, like, ridiculous. Did you see that plort? These freaking... I hate freaking explosive slimes. They always manage to get things to clip through walls. The clunky controls. Yeah, that was... Jet Set Radio, that was originally Dreamcast, right? Dreamcast had some great games, but, you know, that was a very awkward era for controls. Like, controls followed this arc where, like, Atari was, like, garbo, and then it was, like, NES, pretty good. SNES, like, pretty much sweet spot, perfect for 2D. And then you go back to place, you know, to the 3D era, and everything's like plorp, all the way back down to garbage levels. And then you get PlayStation 2, and it's hit and miss. But pretty much every genre has been done right in 3D at this point now. But yeah, Dreamcast. That only had one analog, and that was a weird controller. I want my Dreamcast back, and it was a great system, but there's definitely some jank in there. All right, let's make that red warp depot. I don't know where to put these depots. I don't know if any of these, like, I don't know if there's any other Slime Rancher players in the chat, but I don't know where to put these depots. I haven't even placed a single one, so I'm not even 100% sure what they do. Like, they're supposed to transport, like, materials, but I don't know if they only hold one or what, but I don't know. They use this rare thing to be built, so I don't want to build one and, like, you know, put it in the wrong place and have to take it out. Let's get these farm things going again, I guess. I probably don't need this many heartbeats, but whatever. I'm being lazy. Okay, where am I going again? Volcanic Island. Okay, I know where that is. Wait. Yes. Wait, I think I can get there even faster if I go this way. Especially with the PS2, can lock out your controller and become playable. Locks out all future controllers? Huh. How did you get out? Excuse you? Excuse you? Wait, why is there a Largo in there? You get in there, I guess. This was supposed to be my slime zoo. Oh, I put a bunch of slimes in here. Wait, where did my... Oh, I lost my Hunter Feral, didn't I? This was supposed to be my slime zoo, and it turns out having a slime zoo kind of murders your frame rate. So I might have to cut down my ambitions, and, like, I think these guys in particular, with their glowy stuff, ruin the frame rate. I think I might have to cut down to, like, 10 of each slime. I think that would be manageable. But I have, like, 200. And somebody needs to be banned. Ach. I need to get mods at some point. I hate having to ban people manually. Alright, I think Volcanic Island is this way? I swear this hole used to come out at a different spot. I always feel disoriented when I come out here, but it is the right place. Also, I have the stream playing on two different monitors and the game playing in my middle monitor, and it's very disorienting. Hold on. Alright, that's better. Red slimes look like they need to be toned down. I don't know. I mean, visually, individually, like, they're not a big deal. But I have, like, 40 of them in there, maybe? I don't know. Wait. Is this where I wanted to go? Yes, I think. Yes, it is. Okay. So there's a black thing here somewhere. Oh, you got locked out of a controller playing Kingdom Hearts? Oh, that's a... Oh, is this... Oh, no. There's one around here somewhere. Yeah, I've been spoiled by more recent RPGs that, like, actually autosave and stuff. I remember some horrible instances of losing saves in the PlayStation 2 era and earlier. I lost a lot in particular. I rage quit after... I lost to Atmos in Final Fantasy V, I think that was? Which isn't even super hard if you know, like, exactly what to do, which, you know, is usually the case. I just hadn't saved for a freaking long time, and I just decided, nah, we're not gonna play this anymore. What's this? Red teleporter. Okay.
Okay. And the volcanic island where the pink rad ferals and boom rad ferals spawn. Use the jetpack and nearby crystals to take you to the high path of wooden bridges. You'll see an area holding the pod. Green depot. Okay. I think I know roughly where that is.
Yeah, this game is really colorful. I really like the... It really nails a lot of things really well. It is still in early access, and there is some stuff missing. Before the Slime Science update, you used to be able to hit the end of the game, so to speak, fairly quickly. Like, I think in like 6 hours maybe, but they've added a lot since then. I don't really have any sort of estimate for, you know, how you get to end game anymore. Alright, is this? Hold on. With the pink red ferals and blue ferals, use the jetpack and the ruined red crystals to make a high path with the wooden bridges. Okay. I guess that's this.
Oh, Zealot? Oh, yeah, I remember you from the chat. Yeah, you're gonna not want to use... Oh, there we go!
You're gonna not want to shitpost too hard in this chat. I don't tend to take very kindly to that. Yeah, I do recognize your name. I'll unban you. But, I would recommend not doing that in the future. Wait, how do I unban? Ban user, not... Wait. Ugh. That's why I need moderinos.
You got both rare weapon drops and the die. Oh,
yeah. I would be upset. I've never actually unbanned anyone on Twitch, so I have no idea what I'm doing right now. Security and privacy, maybe? Block whispers. Channel and videos? Chat rules. Oh, there we go. Oh, hey, it tells you who banned people. That's nice. How do I not ban? Banned chatters add. What do you mean? How do I see changes host channels randomly?
Is this thing anything like Minecraft?
Sort of. I mean, Minecraft technically has an ending now, right? But yeah, this is basically... How the hell do you unban people on Twitch?
I guess I should just Google. Twitch says use the unban command. Aw, it's freaking... Why does Twitch love IRC so much?
Now I have to copy the username. Okay. Yeah, command lines are no bueno. I'm a freaking programmer and I don't like... Freaking... I don't know... Okay, you're unbanned. I don't know how... Like, non-technical users even deal with that. I guess most streamers are pretty technical users, but still, that limits your ability to, attract, the more casual users. But yeah, you meme-wise, don't... If I could confuse you for a troll, you're probably gonna get treated like a troll, so don't do that. I try to keep the chat, I read all of my chat and I, try to respond to it. So if people are shitposting, they're not going to be doing it for very long. When attempting to backtrack to the Indigo Quarry Slime Gate entrance, instead of dropping down to the entrance, climb up and look right. What? Yeah, IRC is an old chat room, and lots of command line stuff. Very extensible. There's a lot you can do with it. There's a lot of stuff built on IRC, but it's a very manual, very command line-y thing. It's only possible to build GUI stuff on it, but that doesn't tend to happen very often. Okay, I think it's talking about around here somewhere. Instead of dropping down the entrance, climb right and look off the edge for ledge to the pod. This is... I guess it makes sense that the black, you know, the level 3 treasure pods are the best hidden ones. Hi, Tommy Tuchan. Where are you? I think it's somewhere around here. Ooh, this looks like... No. I always see a thing that like looks like a great place to hide things, and it's never where the thing is hidden. This is Slime Rancher. It's... Well, it's about ranching slimes. You go out in the wild here, you suck up some slimes into your inventory here. You bring them back home, you get stuck in walls, you grow them. You can combine up to two kinds of slimes, like that's a pink rock slime there. And that way, you feed them in your ranch and they produce these crystals you can sell. A recent update added a bunch of crafting. There we go! That is some pretty intense hiding. Yeah, a recent... Ooh! Strange ore whose geometric arrays can sneak in on. Look at your level. Alright, yeah, I was hoping for some more crystal things. Alright, I think we got all three of the... or all six of these. Jumbo Mushrooms, Red Depot, Green Depot, Red Teleporter, Amber Teleporter. Yeah, I think we have all of them now, then. Let me go back home and double-check. But yeah, they released an update just recently that, adds all these treasure things, as well as... mineral extractors, so now there's basically crafting, and you can make teleporters, you can make decorative things. Oh yeah, I forgot there's technically a story. It's in early access, and I don't think... I always forget the character even has, like, well, is a character, so to speak. But yeah, you're some girl that travels to Land of the Slimes, and you're gonna, you know, farm up a bunch of slimes. And ruin your frame rates by putting way too many slimes that you don't even need in a corral, if you're me. Don't be me. I have to kill the slimes to save the frames. But yeah, Slime Ranch is really good. I have a bunch of other videos on my YouTube channel. Rest in peace, slimes. According to lore, they don't even die if they go into the water. They just, like, shbloop. Like, it's slime water, and they, like, shbloop out of the water somewhere else. Still says I'm playing Mario? Really? It never changes that freaking thing. Slime. Ugh. Yeah, sometimes when you input it on the game on Twitch, it just, like, it's like, nah. You're not streaming that. You're still streaming Yoshi, bro. I see that. That's Yoshi. That's one of those. That's a fuzzy, man. That's Yoshi. You know, that's green. That's a Yoshi right there. And that's March and Milda. Yeah, I got you, bro. Have some foods. All right. I just want to confirm that I have all of the things. Okay, so red teleporter, amber teleporter, red warp depot, yeah, we built that earlier, jumbo mushroom, I remember getting that, but yeah, I'll double check, jumbo mushroom, hexium formation, oh yeah, and a green depot. All right, we got everything then. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, let's just make sure that they didn't discover any more of the other ones. 1,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Wait, what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Wait, I could have sworn there was 12 green treasure pods. Whatever. Okay.
Oh yeah, I tweeted out Golden Yoshi's Island. It's made for speedrunning. It's like a remix of a different ROM hack, more designed for speedrunning and, you know, getting rid of some of the more annoying levels. Yeah, I could try that out sometime after I finish actual Yoshi's Island. I really want this number one slime stage. I guess I need a bunch more apiaries. Something that's slightly annoying with how this update, or like how the slime science thing works, is there's these certain really rare materials you need for certain things. I mean, I guess this is pretty standard gameplay stuff. You know, you gotta get the super rare thing to get the super pointless but neat thing. But yeah, in order to get a certain thing, I gotta get some really rare crap that you really can't influence whether you get it or not. You just have to, you know, grind. Oh, happy late birthday. What you got for me? And the annoyance, part of the annoyance with that is like almost all of this stuff that I get is now useless because I have a ton of this like low level common stuff, you know, filthy casual stuff, but I don't have the other stuff. Apiary. Oh, I reached the limit. Yeah, whatever. Rip stream. I think I dropped a few frames, but yeah, just hit F5. Yeah, I think I might have just dropped some frames. I got 5% frame drop. Let's try to slightly reduce that bitrate and see if that... I really wish OBS had some kind of, like, adaptive, like, bitrate feature or something, because sometimes Mediacom's internet just sucks, and, like, if I just reduce the bitrate just a bit, it starts working a bit better. Oh, you're on phone? I'm sure there's some way. If you're on the Chrome browser, you can just drag down and refresh. If you're on the mobile app, I would think it would be smart enough to automatically refresh when the stream is back, but I could be wrong. Mobile apps aren't always good. That's the one thing, like, a lot of people used to be all about the mobile apps instead of the, you know, web apps and stuff. And it's like, in theory, mobile apps can be really great, but very often they are just, you know, a web view. And suck. Alright, so now, can I make this teleporter? Yes, I can. Oh, I need wild honey. Ah, frick. Why do we need honey for a teleporter? Why does God need a starship? Seriously, I can't make a teleporter because I don't have honey. Video games. Okay. So, I need to make, of all the frickin' things. Yeah, unfortunately, I can only get wild honey in a certain location, and I haven't been farming there because I didn't need it until now. So, I guess I gotta go make some things. Wait, why did I go there? More apiaries. I really wish there was a third level of apiary that has, like, frickin' 5 or, like, 10, whatevers. You know, cycles that it goes through. Or, like, a permanent one. I would pay for, like, a permanent one, even if it, like, took twice as long to extract. I really don't like consumable things in video games. Like, I'm one of those people that refuses to use an elixir on the final boss. Because, I mean, what if I need it later, man? You don't know. There could be a third final boss. There could be a post game. You don't know. You don't know things. Only I know things. So yeah, unfortunately, all of the stuff that I'm getting here, I only need strange diamonds. I actually think I have enough strange diamonds to make all of the things, so I don't think I need to make drills for now. Speaking of strange diamonds, I got none of them. Those were only... The only purpose of those drills was to get strange diamonds, and they failed. But yeah, consumables are annoying. I hate the noises those things make. I really wish they'd turn that. I guess I should be reporting that as an issue instead of complaining on stream, but I'll do that. I'll do the boring things when I'm not streaming. Also, I don't know why I even have those cannons. The cannons seem really cool, and then you never really get to see them used. Those water cannons can shoot down, like, evil black slimes if they get created, but as long as you're not stupid, they probably won't happen, so... Kind of pointless. Get out of here. Can you shoot slimes through the teleporter? Aw. Son, I am disappointed. You can go into the water. Do you have stuff for me? No? Oh, whatever. I gotta sleep. This is the fun part of the game where you get to sleep until things give you stuff. Since they added that slime plush to the house thing. They have to make a real slime plush when the game is released. They are legally obligated to do so. They can't tease you like that. Yeah, just don't give me the one thing I wanted you to give me. Thank you. That's nice. Hey, Sam. Though at least, like... Regarding hoarding stuff, at least a decent amount of modern RPGs at least let you keep stuff, like do a new game plus or whatever. I really think most games, even the games that have new game pluses, don't tend to do them very well though, which is frustrating. Like, I already mentioned Neptunia, like, always had some really weird restrictions on the new game plus stuff. Like, you wouldn't be able to keep the characters until the very last, update. I guess I should put a teleporter where I can get the frickin' honey, because I always have to run all the way out here. I think there's a... Yeah, I'll just put a teleporter out. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, but Hyper Dimension Neptunia... Mega Dimension Neptunia finally has a new game plus where you can reset your levels, you can choose to keep all of your characters, you can choose whether you want to keep items. It's basically like, it's like a Tales of series unlock, like, New Game Plus. Except you don't have to pay, like, 18 billion grade, you know. To unlock the cool options in Tales of, you had to have to beat the game, like, 5 times. Which is just dumb, because, I mean, seriously, just let me use the cool features. Like, I already beat it once, which is more times than most people ever beat a game. So let me play with all of the fun stuff the second time around. Even though there's a full way to have the vid full screen, but have the live chat still up. If you go to night mode on YouTube Gaming, that's basically what it is. It's like, you know, 80% of the screen will be the game and 20% will be chat. Oh, it's the freaking cat thing. Oh wait, no, you have to feed the cat. Yeah, you have to feed the cat chickens. Oh, there's already a tar here. I guess I should put a water cannon here. Oh, I had an apiary here this whole time. Ah, there's the wild honey I needed. Yeah, I need this honey for teleporters. You know, science. That's how it works. I guess I should put a freaking water cannon here. Do I have? Yeah. Advanced apiary. Man, there's almost no places to put stuff here. Aw, come on. Yeah, I like Tails games, but like, I'm not gonna... I played Exilia twice, and there was like one trophy keeping me from platinum. There's this like rare enemy trophy that like, you have to go back and forth to this one enemy spawn point, like literally several hundred times in order to try and get that trophy. I hate trophies like that. Why do you do that? Why would you do this? What did I do to deserve this? Anyway. Alright, speaking of trophies, I think there's one I need to get by holding a slime for like 15 seconds, so hold on. I'm just gonna get my face eaten for a few minutes here. I think you just basically have to let it go right before you die. Playing one- oh. It died. Okay. Yeah, speaking of Tails every 2 years, that's pretty much how I feel. I haven't played since Exilia, and I'm not sure if I'm going to get Tales of Berezia either. I guess it depends on whether or not they screw up having their first, like, real female protagonist. Because, you know, Mila was, like, half. It's like theater mode, shaping the reach. Yeah, there's also theater mode on not YouTube gaming. Are you done installing yet? Oh. Yeah, all of them are dead, and finally it finishes setting up. I guess... wait. Oh, I was supposed to set up a thing. A teleport thing. I'm stupid. Is there a slot left? I guess I can put it... no, I want to put it here. Ah, I'm stupid. Well... I'm not sure if the cannon works as well from here, but I'm going to put it here. See, the hydro cannons, you can place them and pick them up and, like, replace them. But other stuff you can't, and that's annoying. So, do I want pink or green? I guess moss blanket, green, sure. I should have made the purple one go to the indigo quarry, because, I mean, that's as close as you can get. Okay, now I just have to sleep and wait for more precious honeys. Random black screen. I guess I'm still dropping frame. I really think it really just has to be MediaCom at this point. I wonder if they have like business internet that I could get that like is less sucky and hopefully costs less than like $1 billion a month. I don't know if that's a thing they let you do. PSP version of Star Ocean. I've actually never played a Star Ocean game. I was a little tempted by the new one. I hear it's like not as bad as the PS3 one, which, you know, high praise. But I don't know. I don't really have a ton of time for RPGs. In fact, I feel a little guilty playing this instead of other stuff. Like, I've only played like 5 maybe hours of Pokemon Sun Moon. I just got off the first island, if that's a decent indicator. Alright, what precious goods do you have? Aw, come on, 30 seconds? Star Ocean 1 to 3 are great. Yeah, I had heard that like everything before the PS3 one was really good, and everyone's like really confused by the fourth one. Chicken. Alright, what you got for me? I need my honey for my teleporters. Isn't science... the power of science is amazing. I was so glad. That guy was like the only good part of the intro of Pokemon Sun and Moon. Like, I get that they're going for like the more cinematic approach with Sun and Moon, but that intro was way too much. Like, they did some cool stuff. Like, well, I don't want to spoil things, but like, the very first bits of it were all right, but then it's like, they take like an hour to do this, like it's the Pallet Town tour, but it takes an hour, and like, that's really unnecessary. Wait, were these chickens here before? They keep adding things to the game, and it like, it feels really weird playing a game in like active development. Cause like, things that you used to know are no longer true, and it's like, it hurts your brain a little bit. I don't usually play early access games, but this one looked really cute, and it doesn't have that early access stink to it. You know, some games it's like, oh yeah, this is obviously early access, but like this one, not so much. Alright, so I just need 4 more wild honeys and I can make the last teleporter. I don't even know where I want my last 2 teleporters to go, but I wanna have them. There's some stuff in this game where I don't really understand why it has like a timey requirement, because you can just go to sleep. And then you can do the farming, so I don't know. I think this was my, yeah. Brawlhalla? I've heard of that, but I haven't played it. And by heard of it, I mean I recognize the name, but nothing else. HD Symphonia combo. Oh yeah, I got the PS3 version of that. I guess that was a silly idea. I should have like expected it to eventually go to PC. Though they hadn't done any PC ports yet, so I guess I wouldn't have known. But yeah, that was not the best port. It was a port of the PS2 version, which was 30 FPS, and the GameCube version was 60. I played the GameCube version, but I rented it from borrowed it from a friend, which that was like the longest I've ever borrowed a game. I played it like 200 hours. But yeah. Great game, but it really could have used a little bit of editing on the gameplay side, at least in the combat side. Everything else is still great. Alright, we can make all of our teleporters. I still need... Ugh, this freaking lava dust is so rare, I hate it. Brawlhalla's freeze in beta, it's a fighting game, kind of like Smash. I guess I should have figured that from the name, but I don't really play too many fighting games. Best games, worst games, and scariest games I've ever played. I don't really do lists like that. Like Yoshi's Island was obviously a very important game for me. I don't know. I can't really recommend best and worst, especially worst, because like, usually when I just really don't enjoy a game, it's just like I just stop playing it. So like, I can't really say how awful it is. I just like know that it wasn't for me, so I stopped. As far as scary, like for horror games, I definitely recommend Silent Hill, Fatal Frame, and early Resident Evil. Resident Evil follows such a weird arc. Like, the first one is like okay for like campy garbage. 2 and 3 are pretty good for that classic survival horror feel. Not as good as Silent Hill, but still quite good. The remake of 1 ditches the like campy aspect and is just good old survival horror. But pretty much the first four Silent Hills are pretty much required playing, in my opinion. And then the first 2 Fatal Frames. So I haven't played, I got the PS2 on PS3 version of Fatal Frame 3, but I never got too far. I think it's supposed to be pretty good. Games I've played the most? Well, that's mostly just because like long RPG stuff, but I played a ton of Pokemon. I played Disgaea 3. Like, there's a couple of Disgaea games I played over 100 hours in. And with Disgaea, it's pretty much... You can pick any one of them and play a crap ton. But usually, You want the latest one for the latest, you know, improvements. Because they do some really nice grinding and optimizations in that game, or series. Hey, Diamond.
So...
I guess I just need to build a bunch more pumps so I can get that stupid... what did I want? Oh yeah, the warp depots. Pretty much just want to get the last of my constructions now. The dust is in the sub-lava area with an advanced pump. Are you sure about that? I've heard people say that, but it just seems to be a random drop from anywhere. Did I ever play the Binding of Isaac Rebirth? Oh yeah, I have the platinum from Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I tend to avoid roguelikes just because I don't tend to like the difficulty, and if I do, they eat up so much time. So I kind of don't want to like them. I kind of wish you could set up a corral to go straight up to put the plort straight into the foundry here. Because the slime, there's a lot of grinding involved in the Slime Science Update, and not all of it is enjoyable grinding. Like, some of it's just, you know, take plorts, move plorts. You know, it feels like this could be automated. Oh, have I played Afterbirth? No, I haven't played Afterbirth. I was pretty much done. As soon as I cheesed my way through the Lost, I decided I was pretty much done. I would probably still like it, but I have other stuff to play. I just like to, you know, play a good variety of stuff. Like, I would rather play 10 5-hour games than one 50-hour game. You know, provided they're not, like, terrible games, obviously. Six advanced pumps placed near the cave near lava. Huh. I'll try it. Hopefully I can make six pumps. The biggest annoyance I would say with the Slime Science Update is just moving plorts around. Especially- aw, dang it, I didn't want that. Now I need boom plorts again. I think game theory just keeps getting worse, and I never liked game theory, but they seem to get even more crazy, and in my opinion, they always started out crazy. But there was somebody that that Ed said was pretty close. I forget where, but if you... But yeah, somebody had theories that Ed said were pretty close. This was before Afterbirth, though. Yeah, I've completed... I don't know how long I played, because on the PS4 version, it doesn't really track how long you played. But I got the platinum of the original version. And, I partially cheesed, the Lost. So I probably didn't waste as much time as a lot of people did, but... In my opinion, I probably enjoyed it a lot more. Until it's modded. Yeah, that's the other thing. I have it on PS4. I guess it wouldn't be too big of a deal to buy Afterbirth on PC. So, you know, it's not that expensive considering how much game it has. But, I don't know. I feel pretty done. I think it's a game, like, maybe I'll go back to it in a few years or something. But, like, I played enough Binding of Isaac for, you know, a couple of years, really. That's how I feel with certain, like, games. Like, Tales of... I played Ixilia. I think I got, like, 2 or 3 years worth of Tales out of that game. I don't need to play it for a while. I played Metal Gear Solid 5, and that was enough sandbox AAA game for a year or so. I played Uncharted 4, and that was enough, you know, AAA, bombastic, cinematic, whatever, for a year. Like, I enjoyed those, but, like, I don't need too many of them. They're filling, I guess. Also, with Binding of Isaac, like, I just have to be worried that, you know, what stupid thing is Ed gonna add that makes everything incredibly unfun? Because, I mean, with Rebirth, it was the Lost. And then, I guess, the Keeper is even worse, so, I mean, what stupid thing am I gonna hate in the new one? Like, there's always some, big fuck you to completionists, and I really don't appreciate that. New item slots? What do you mean new item slots? Like, ability to hold more items in Isaac? That would be weird. Exception of FNAF 4 is dead on. Huh. I think Five Nights at Freddy's, like, that was kind of the point. Like, it was intentional that you'd be able to find things, though. Like, there's not always, like, actually something there. So, like, some games I could see them doing, like, right on, you know. I guess Isaac is sort of a game where you're supposed to be able to figure some stuff out. DBH the Keeper is really cool. You start with Triple Shot. Though, that makes you... Triple Shot makes you really slow, though. So, like, in certain fights, that can be really bad. Oh, a new type of item? Oh, like, you know, spacebar item versus card item and stuff. That could be interesting. The physics for these poor things are so weird. See, good old physics. Oh, you're working now. These usually, like, launch you up after a while. I think I'm gonna head out for now. I'm not sure if I'll stream later today. Maybe. Might stream Project High Rise or something. I'm not sure if I want to do a stream for that or just like a regular video. But that's like a Sim Tower game. I mentioned that earlier. Yeah, it's a pretty cool Sim Tower modern sort of thing. Hey, Sorten. I was just mentioning that I was about to leave. Sorry. I might stream later. Probably. I can't believe I'm still dropping 6% of frames. Like, it's not horrible, but it's still bad. Ugh. I really wish there was literally any other option. I was honestly considering there's DSL service here. And it has like 10 megabits per second upload. I was honestly considering seeing if that is like acceptable to stream on. It would definitely be worse in terms of like maximum numbers, but if I could get a consistent 3 megabits per second up, that would actually sadly be better. Oh, also the amber slime lamp is so sad. You have to see this. The other two slime lamps are super happy and stuff, but the amber slime lamp is like dead or like starving. Like here he comes. He's like, "Argh." The other ones are so happy and this one's like starving. Like, let me show you the other ones. The other ones are so happy. See, the violet one's happy. This one's happy. But the amber one's just, like, dying. Did you get that pic I sent you on Facebook? I haven't checked Facebook much lately, so no, probably not. Let me open it right now. Facebook.com/SirTapTap. I have new notifications. I do check my messages in Facebook, but, like, expect that, like, once a month. Generally, you want to send stuff on Twitter. Oh, yeah, regarding the... If you, in Binding of... Or, in anything Steam... Hola, sir. Vacano to video de Endless War 5. Someone is requesting Endless War 5, apparently. That's not what I wanted to...
You must have sent it as like a comment, not a message. I'm looking on Facebook here for whatever we got. Did I already dismiss the notification? Notifications? Oh yeah, here we go. how do I download this? Yeah, somebody else, how do we... Yeah, I was talking on stream earlier about this bad Gen 1 sprite for Hitmonchan. And... James found this. How do I put this on? Oh, nope. Feels like I'm wearing nothing at all. Nothing at all. Nothing at all. Beautiful. Hey, Mr. Rosen. Everybody pours in, like, right when I'm about to leave. And showing you these horrible things. I wish I could stream Pokemon, but that's probably the last game on 3DS where I will wish that I had a capture card. So, I'm, you know, capture card's like $300 for those. And I would have to buy a new 3DS, too. So it's like $500 total, and I would stream, like, just a few things, and then the Switch would kill it, so I just can't. But, yeah, I've been enjoying Pokemon Sun Moon. It's good. I do have some complaints, but I'm not super far. The SOS battles are a little annoying. It seems like something that you should be able to, like, have better control over whether you want it to happen. Or it should just be faster. The entire problem is that it's slow. But, yeah, overall, I like most of the changes in Sun Moon, but there's just definitely some stuff that was changed just because of, like, they wanted to change things. The beginning area is still really slow. Like, the first trial was hilariously pathetic. They're like, you're gonna go into this cave, and you're gonna fight the strongest things you've ever fought in your entire life. It's gonna be amazing. It's gonna be an adrenaline rush, and few will survive. And then you go in there, and it's just a bunch of Rattatas, which is literally, there are Rattatas that are level 11 outside of the cave, and you go into, you know, the Cave of Destiny, and there are level 12 Rattatas, and that's all that's in there. And then you fight a level, you know, a Team Skull Grunt, and he's got a level 12 Zubat, which I can't believe. The first Team Skull Grunt you fight has a fucking Zubat, and I'm like, god damn it. You had one job. Of all of the things to not change, they kept the villains have stupid Zubats, and like, just one Zubat, and it's like, there's so many good Pokemon they could have. There's so many evil Pokemon. They could have, like, literally any dark type Pokemon is more fitting than a freaking Zubat for the villain team. And Zubats. Just Zubats. But yeah. And then there's a cave. The first cave you find, of course it has Zubats. What else would they put? It's not like there's dozens of other cave Pokemon they could put in there. You know, it's gotta be a Zubat. It's gotta be the Zubat. I guess you could see it as lampshading, but like, there's so many other things they changed just to change it. Like, there's no more badges. There's 8 trials, but those aren't gyms. They're trials. It's different. You know, trials are totally not. You know, you don't get badges. You get Z crystals. Those aren't badges. Like, there's so many things that are just deliberately just changed enough to get people to not complain. But then they leave the Zubats in. Like, there's 2 different Zubat-related things that I hate, and they left both of them in. Like, there's the Zubat cave, and there's the villains having Zubats. Oh, hello, Parker. Yes, hello. Yes, yes. Hi. Hi. But yeah, why the Zubats? Of all of the things to not fix, like, the one thing that I would really appreciate them fixing. It sucks because Zubat isn't a bad Pokemon, but I've seen so many Zubats, I just kind of never want to see one again.
Parker's just sitting on my desk like, hi, you aren't petting me. Would you like to correct the situation? Looks like you aren't petting a cat. Would you like help? Geometry. This game loves shoving you in geometry. You can always get out, but it's always just a little bit weird. Anyway, I don't need all of these pink slimes. We're gonna have to genocide these pink slimes. Oh, you can hear him? Good. I'm never sure if you can hear him on stream. He's usually actually pretty quiet when I'm talking. Like, he's just sitting here. He's like, hi. Why don't you talk? Mew. He's like, you don't know my words. You don't know the plight of my people. Do not presume. He's just staring me down. Hi. But yeah, overall, I do like Sun Moon, but there's some just baffling stuff that they did not change. And, fashion is still incredibly expensive, which is frustrating, because, like, fashion is the best thing that Gen 6 added, and I legitimately did not play Omega Ruby because I did not want to play as in the same clothes the entire game. It was just that big of a feature in the other game, in Pokemon Y. It was the best. Yeah, overall, Sun Moon, I would definitely recommend it, though it does seem like it's coming to Switch, probably. There's a lot of good evidence to that. Like, Sun Moon doesn't have 3D at all, which seems like a hint. There's rumors, but I mean, there's always rumors. It definitely seems like a Switch port is possible, and it would look a lot better. Hello, yes, and hopefully the doubles battle frame rate would suck less. Isn't there a? I thought I put Hunter Slime in here. Oh wait, That's why I have Hunter Slimes. Okay, let's just leave those in there. Finally, back to the superior third version. Yeah, I was of the school that we don't really need third versions anymore because we have the remakes. But I guess if it's a port to a different system, I mean, that's a bit different. But yeah, if Pokemon Stars is real and on Switch, that's probably the version you'd want, but if you want one last great game for your 3DS, Sun Moon seems to mostly be it. Though, the cinematicness, the very first area, like they try so hard to make everything so intense, and then you're still fighting, like, one guy with a level 10 Rattata, and it's like, oh. And they make such a big deal of it. Like, they try so hard, and then it's a guy with Rattata, and you're just like, yeah. It's no matter how much dressing you put on it, a guy with Rattata is still just a guy with Rattata. Anyway, I think I'm gonna stop streaming for a bit. Was in the top percentage of Rattata. You know what? They had a guy. They had a youngster Joey. And Joey looks like he's like 4 years old in Sun Moon. And he didn't tell me about shorts. He didn't tell me about Rattata. He didn't even have a Rattata. He didn't have a top percentage. He was just Joey. And I didn't even know what to think. It's like he's Joey in name only. I was a bit disappointed in that. Because, like, it just felt like they felt inclined to have a youngster Joey, but they didn't really want to make it Joey. My shorts are in the bottom 7% of denim. I do like the change-ups in the character models, the new Lass is good. Everyone, like, all of the characters are pretty good. I mean, generally, they've had good designs in general, like, XY had great trainer designs too, but for how much different they are, they're pretty good. Only one to make Pokemon gameplay intense nowadays is Nuzlocke. Ugh, I could never do Nuzlocke stuff. It is a little bit easy, but I mean, I never really had too much trouble, or too much to complain about that way. I do wish they had more. I just wish trainers had more Pokemon, and that there were more double and triple battles, because those, like, changed things up a bit. My years of an FE player prevent me from playing Nuzlocke. Yeah, I can't play anything with permadeath unless it's, like... like, mystery dungeon stuff I'm okay with. I mean, that's, like... I don't lose my characters, you just lose some, like... you lose some items and stuff, but you don't lose your peoples. I can't play games where I lose peoples. It's not okay. I can barely lose frickin' Pikmin. That'll still... that ticks me off. If I lose more than 5 Pikmin, like, I get tempted to reset the day. I don't know. I could maybe do a Nuzlocke where I send my Pokemon into, like, Pokemon Bank when they, you know, get knocked out. I'd be okay with that. But nah, I can't. I'm not gonna release them. That's not gonna happen. And yeah, I would probably... if I, like, were forced to do that, I would just, like, go to a Pokemon Center after every fight and, like, grind and stuff. And that would just defeat the purpose of doing a Nuzlocke anyway. Pixelmon? That sounds familiar. Oh, is that the... I think there was some... Pyco 8 game like that. Is that the Pyco 8 one? Oh, it's a Minecraft mod. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, yeah, I think I've heard of that. There is a Pyco 8 Pokemon clone that I did want to check out. I think it's in my review queue on itch.io. Every once in a while, someone comes back and asks me to play Minecraft. I have a bunch of Minecraft videos from, like, 2012 or something? From the beta or the alpha. And I had fun with Minecraft, but I just can't play the same game for, like, 18 billion hours. Like, I've played this game for more than I play most games, really. But yeah, Pixelmon is some kind of, like, Pokemon in Minecraft. Which frustrates me, because Minecraft isn't, like... I don't know. Minecraft's art style is just baffling. The cheat's physiology is just plain baffling. But yeah. I have been hoping that one of those, like, Minecraft but with an art style games would be really good. Like, I kind of wanted to, like, monster... or... what is it called? Dragon Quest Builders? But at the same time, I don't... it's like a roguelike. I could see myself playing it for 100 hours, but I don't have 100 hours, so... I kind of wanted not like it. So, I just kind of passed. I played the demo, and it seemed interesting, but I just decided, nah. I have to play Pokemon and Final Fantasy... World of Final Fantasy. I guess I could stream that, maybe. I might play that today. But... yeah, I don't know. I play so many games, I don't want to spend a billion hours. Yeah, World of Final Fantasy, I think I'll really like that one. That looks really cute, and it seems to have all of the Final Fantasy stuff that Final Fantasy stopped doing. I'm not getting Final Fantasy 15. I'll get it eventually. Which is what I said about Final Fantasy 13, which I still don't own, by the way. So maybe I won't, but I don't know. World of Final Fantasy, I think I will really like. Yeah, I don't know. I might play a little bit of Minecraft at some point. Like, I might stream, I don't know. But most of the new stuff, like, I don't know. It's just, this is just too much. In Minecraft now, it's just too complicated. Like, when I always thought it was a little bit too early when I played it before, but then they added all of the stuff. It's like, oh, maybe it was fine. I don't know. Yeah, I've said I was gonna stop streaming like 4 times now. I'm just gonna feed these guys and Castaway too. I've not heard of that. Yeah, I've been trying to get back to PSVR. I got put off just because it's just enough difficult. Like, it's kind of hard to record that stuff. And then I got really busy. But I got 4 videos of PSVR games ready, and I'll probably try to have a week or so of, like, PSVR games on the channel. Not streaming, because streaming those is also, that's like even more annoying. Because then I can't see the chat. Like, I have to open up menu to see the chat, and it's just, it's not ideal. But yeah, I'll be playing some more PSVR games on the YouTube channel soon. Can't really imagine talking about the Minecraft art style. I mean, is Minecraft even an art style? It's like, oof. I think there's some images of like early Minecraft characters where like it had an interesting art style going on, but they, I really don't like the style I ended up going with. Wait, I want to see. Excellent. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! I almost forgot. I didn't show you the. I've put all my puddle slimes in here. So they just have a nice little place to gather plorts. And all my feral boom slimes kind of wander around and explode. And I figured they would produce more plorts, but they really don't. So I think I might have to get rid of the feral boom slimes. Oh, they're doing the boogies! Wait, why are there five of you in here? There shouldn't be five of you. Okay, there's four in here. Yeah, I kind of always needed some place to have water. Okay, I guess you guys have a new friend. Wait, where did he go? How did you get outside? Stay in the water. Calm down. What are you doing? What is this problem? Stay in the water. There you go. Sheesh. Wait, that's what Pixelmon looks like? That's just like... Like, that's just Mew from, like... That looks like Mew from Pokemon Snap. Which, by the way, the Pokemon Snap mode in Sun Moon is really disappointing. It sounded really cool, but when you play it, it's like only very, very specific places have the things, the places where you can take pictures. And like, there's very, very few Pokemon that show up, and you have very limited control. It's just way too limited in all possible regards. Yeah, everybody wanted Pokemon Snap with 3D or the Wii U, though 3DS would have worked too. But yeah, I guess they weren't interested. The Pokemon Snap, looking back at it, that was like almost a ripoff. It was like good for what there was of it, but like I think it was like a full priced game, and it's like 3-4 hours. I actually liked Hey You Pikachu a lot, and I really wish I could emulate it, but I don't think you can. I don't have I have an N64 again, but I don't have Hey You Pikachu. It's actually part of why I bought one. Anyway, I'm gonna head out for now, and maybe I'll play World of Final Fantasy, maybe I'll play Project Highways, I don't know. But maybe I'll stream later today. But I need to give my voice a rest. And, plan out some stuff. I actually don't know what I'm going to do with my long weekend, but I kind of need to just rest. Yeah, the thing with Hey You Pikachu, you can't emulate the mic. It's like really weird hardware level stuff, and nobody's gotten it working yet. But yeah, that's part of why I got it. I hope it's not too expensive to get anymore. I bought the N64 before I got Hey You Pikachu, and I ended up not really using it much. But oh well. Thanks for watching, everybody. And yeah, if I stream again today, it'll probably be at 6 p.m. Central, which is in 2.5 hours. Not 100% sure I will, but I might.